Hi there and welcome back, my friends, to Crusader Kings 2, to the Kingdom of Nenetia and Finland. We have done it, my friends. We have set this to primogeniture. The oldest child of the ruler inherits all titles. Well, but this still is dependent on, as you can see here, the primary titles. So, Nenetia and all of the titles that belong to the Kingdom of Nenetia will belong to Prince Skrungles of Nenetia. Then though we have other titles, and these will go to, as you can see here, Prince Total of Nenetia. He's heir to the Kingdom of Finland, and all titles below that. Then we have Einar of Nenetia, who is heir to another independent title of the two kingdoms, the Jarldom of Osterbotten. Well, that's not bad. They will all have something, and that's good. Now, the thing is, though, if we want to strengthen our... look at that. We can forge a bloodline as an ambition. Yeah, we should do that, right? Rule at peace for 30 years, my goodness. We'll try something, right? Let's see. Have we done something? We have murdered or executed 30 people. Oh, we have built 10 cities, 10 castles, or 10 temples. Oh, what would be the cheapest thing? I mean, he would be really someone. I don't think we have enough time to build 10 castles or 10 cities or 10 temples. I think 10 temples would be the cheapest thing, but where do we even have room for something like that? I mean, we could have room something here. Look at that. We could build temples, but the thing is, right now, as we have, we're still the King of Nenetia, right? And the thing we want to do is, now that we have went to primogeniture, we can do two things, basically. Two things are something that are worth something. We could try to found a new empire. For that, we would need a third kingdom title or a very big realm size. So we can look at the realms here. I mean, we have King Thordil, the monster of Nordorike. That's maybe a little bit bad. We have King Odder of Norik, though, our kinsman and heir to the chiefdom of Medelpad. And we'll have to see. What is that? The defensive pact opposing King Arran. And he has two non-aggression pacts. He has this. Yeah, well, the Kingdom of Norik. Could we somehow claim the Kingdom of Norik? Would that be something that is possible? And what would we have to do to get a claim to that? The Kingdom of Norik. I mean, I think it is out of our reach. We could send someone to Helsingland and see what we could claim there, right? We have these, he has these three counties. Helsingland, which is personally Medelpad, and Tavastehus, where some kids are ruling. Then we also have Nidaros, but that's not a kingdom anymore, I believe. Or is it? Let's look. Let's have a look. No, it's a pity kingdom, probably. Got this. Herdalen. I mean, what could we get? He would have to have a lower rank than us. Establish a tributary state. Not really. Border dispute over Helsingland. If we win the war against the country of Helsingland. And it's Helsingland that counts, right? For the Duchess. So that's something that could be good, but how could we be able to do that? How could we get a third kingdom? So is there another possibility? We could make our kingdom pretty, pretty big. But what's the size of 180? And where do we get our realm size shown? Is that our size? 95? It could be. Could as well be. So that's the Netzia. What else would we need? 8,000 prestige. That is something we could reach. 1,000 gold, we could definitely reach that. So that's the one thing. We could go for founding a new empire. The other thing is definitely building a lot of stuff or winning a lot of wars. But recently we've had peace with the people that are close to us. Well, maybe not with these Khans here. And not with this man. Can't cut the just. So we have to decide if we want to fulfill the ambition, which is probably more human, or do something weird here in Norik to found an empire. Among other things, we would want to look what the Kingdom of Nenetsia really means. And what its de jure thing is, the Duchy of Mezen. Yeah, we have much more than the... Yeah, the de jure we have, the Jarlam of Bjarmia. That is ours. We have the Jarlam of Kargopol. Everything there is ours. We have the Duchy of Mezen. Everything there is ours. The Jarlam of Petchora, which means the county of Tsilma would be up for grabs. We'll have to note that down. So Petchora and Tsilma would be in Nenetsia. And that would strengthen our primary realm. Then we have the Jarlam of Welsk. In the Jarlam of Welsk, we have the Chiefdom of Pinnegar. That belongs to Vladimir. That is something we could somehow get, but we are friends to Vladimir at the moment, as we wanted to convert them. This thing, though, we would really like to get it. Okay, back to Nenetsia. We have the Jarlam of Severod, that is completely ours. And that is it. So we're only missing two of these counties here. Let's see what else is there. We have Kuloy, we have Kajana, that is part of a totally other thing. We have Dwina, We have Okladinova with a temple included. We have Onega. Okay. So generally not that good land here. We have Velsk, which is exceptional, where we could build something in the future if we wanted. And that would be a good thing to have. Then we have Pinega, which has a temple. And we have this holding, which has another barony. And we could build a new holding there. So that would be strengthening Nenetsia. Is there something we could do so that Nenetsia is enough to build, to have a new empire? I mean, we could lead wars, we could murder people like mad. Building something is out of the question. Ruling at peace for 30 years is very unlikely. We could execute 30 people to found a bloodline, but that's really not something we would do, and that would make sense for our character, right? Win 15 foreign wars. Nah, he's not the man to go for countless wars. Maybe he has fulfilled his ambition. I think that is not likely. So founding a new empire is probably the way to go somehow. So we would need to find a way to get our hands on Norig. And this means... what does this mean? First, we'll look at what we would need to claim Norig as, or usurp the title. What would we need? There's a High Chiefdom of Iceland. The Duchy of Jämtland would be something that is here. We have the Petty Kingdom of Nidaros. That is here. It's pretty far away. Duchy of Nordreya, that belongs to it. My goodness, that's far away. Duchy of Westlandet. Yeah, that has something really nice, but... And the Duchy of Wiccan. That's a really bad plan. That's a really bad plan. Then it's even easier to look to Northericky. Let's see what this man has. He has pacts, but he has only... He has a non-aggression pact with us because of his wife. That is our daughter. So we probably shouldn't attack him, right? That would make no sense. Then there are other kingdoms, of course, or something like that. And they are here. Look at this. He has a lot of duchies. Yitrkid clan. But he has no high chiefdom. So whatever this is, it's a little bit crazy. Then we have Komi. His liege is a duke. And that's a duchy. This one. There's a High Chieftess, the High Chieftess of Perm. And we have the Kagan Kiza of Georgia, who has all of this. My goodness. That's maybe not the best. To found an empire. So what we should do, or should try, is maybe, I mean, it makes no sense here. We are still ambitious, but yeah, we would definitely have to need claims to go for this and for this. So it would make sense to not go directly for the empire, but to take it on one by one. And we could declare a war. Could we declare a war here on this guy? Not really. But why not? Ah, because he's subject to Kagan Arslan of Khazaria. And that's Khazaria. My goodness. That's a little bit much. He has a lot of troops and a lot of allies. If tried that once, it's terrible. If Kantalati. And Kantalati. The county of Kantalati belongs to the kingdom of Nordrigi and the Jarlam of Kola, and the Empire of Scandinavia. King Wiglaik the Drunkard of Nidaros could be an opponent. We'll have to look to Vladimir, to King Moksha, who likes us. We're kind of neutral towards him. But we have a non-aggression pact. You can see here. Because we've married him to our half-sister. Well done. Well, we've helped them convert as well. So, we're in a terrible situation to advance. Anywhere. We have something here. Look at this. What is this? What belongs this to? The county of Java. Belongs to the High Chiefdom of Sakala. And that belongs to the Kingdom of Estonia. Aha! Look at this, my people. There is the chance we've been looking for. I'm sorry for going through all of this with you, but that's the process we sometimes go through, right? Uusimaa? Well then. So we'll have to look at something here. Let's see what is easiest. So we'll have to go for the Kingdom of Estonia. Let's note that down. That's the easiest one to get, where we already have control of two counties. Chief Eirik of Gdov. Huvachov the Liberator. And the thing is, the problem we have is they are all Germanic. That's not something we really want to do, but if it comes to it. For example, this man is independent, but he has tons of armies. And we have this man, Eirik of Gdov, who has no levies at all. He has a pact with Gutfried Ulfing, the King of Saxony, who is currently very weak. Extremely weak. But who has more allies with this guy of Nidaros, and so that's a possibility. We're already standing here. Let's order this back. Sigtrygg and Wiltrud. Inspiring cavalry leader, Gudröder. Yeah, the depressed, inspiring leader. We can create the Duchy of Meissen. Now, here we go. That's something we have to do. Tartu. What would we want to have? Forcing vassalization. That would include the Kingdom of Saxony. Border dispute over that. If we win the war, we gain the county of Tartu. And that could be enough for the Kingdom of Estonia. Extorting tribute, establishing a tributary state. That here, the zealots, they won't say yes, of course. But the others are okay with that. And quite frankly, let's do that, because now is the time. And we're ambitious. That's the war. And now we will be at war with Saxony as well. Saxony is here. It's currently getting invaded by someone. What is that? Occupied by Wickman of Wickman's host. We have some people here. Jarl Skúli of Östergötland. And we can order some people from here. These are our troops. Yeah, we'll of course order these. Let's collect a couple of troops. We'll collect them over here and then march over. And we don't want the king in this. We will choose someone else. Viltrud, Sigtrygg and Gudrod are in the main army. Yeah, let's go for Snorri. We're a craven, so we will not lead any troops, I guess. I mean, we could go for a warrior training, but at this point we don't want to. No, our wife won't become court jester. Crusade is targeting our religion. Yeah, I know. So that said, that was long talk, right? But it was necessary, and we'll start this war in the next episode. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other then, and hopefully we'll be able to do something. There's the folk of Saxony, and in Essex, well, we'll have some troops, but the majority will come over here, and we'll get these troops as well, hopefully. That's another couple of troops at least. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. This is Immanuel Kahn signing out. See you soon, my friends.